the whole ethos of the Arab Research Centre is all about supporting like-minded individuals and organisations, and essentially about community sharing, contacts and supporting one another in achieving the main objective, which is promoting the Arab world to the British public.
The Arab British Centre has been running for 30 years and it started in South Kensington and our office is now in the city in Gough Square.
For the British public, it's very important for them to understand more about the culture of the Arab world.
The Arab British Centre, I feel, they're a conduit through which the Middle East and what's happening here becomes closer.
We're fully independent as well. We're not politically associated with anything. We don't rely on any government for funding.
We have a community spirit within the centre itself. We house like-minded organisations. We see ourselves as an incubator of those like-minded organisations. We provide free gallery space for up-and-coming artists who want to exhibit their work.
They agreed to meet me to discuss it in detail and were really, really receptive to the ideas. And for me, there was no other centre other than the Arab British Centre that would have given me the platform to be able to do that.
We also have a library of modern Arabic fiction and translation, which is open to the public.
A hugely successful Arab film festival last year at the ICA in London, where we introduced a vast number of the British, of the London public, to popular Arab cinema.
Safar means, is an Arabic word for journey, and we decided that we wanted to take audiences, especially British audiences, on a journey through a very, take them on an exciting journey through popular Arab cinema to show them a kind of notion of Arab cinema that hadn't been represented here in this part of the world.
And it was a festival that didn't dwell on politics or the strife of today, but enjoyed a public that came to laugh and to discover a new world. When we first heard that we had won the UNESCO prize, we could hardly believe it. We were delighted and terribly grateful to everyone who has helped us towards this.
Because we're a very small charity and we really, I think we punch above our weight. We do a lot more work than most people would imagine we could. So getting the recognition of the UNESCO Prize is huge because it shows that we can achieve the same sort of things that much larger organizations with much more funds can achieve. And it also means that we're being recognized for our unique approach of looking at underrepresented communities, maybe marginalized artists, artists from backgrounds that wouldn't normally be seen.
I think it's very important for Western audiences to understand the Arab world is not a single entity, it's not homogeneous. It's actually very, very rich and very diverse, and it's really important that that is showcased in a positive but honest way.
We need to celebrate the good success stories that are going on in the region right now. And those success stories are being sort of obscured by the conflict. So that's why we need to do our work right now here.
My dream for the Arab British Centre is along the lines of the Institut du Monde Arabe. We would love a bigger building with greater facilities and the opportunity to embrace more Arab culture and show it to the British public.